In the 1980s, social activists and scholars, the late Hema Raikar and Gee Poitwa, came across a unique musical phenomenon in rural Maharashtra. In various villages throughout the state, they found many women who hadn't received formal education composing and singing these heartfelt songs about joys, struggles, and triumphs. The women didn't perform for hundreds or thousands of people, but rather in their kitchens, and it all happened around an everyday tool that was used to crush grain, the grind mill. Since then, over 100,000 such songs, or OVI as it's called in Marathi, have been documented with the help of researchers, technologists, translators, journalists, and activists. This is the Grind Mill Songs Project, and it is a window into the lives of people we rarely see or hear about.
सांगते महिना तुला हुरद उकल त्याच्यापाशी त्या काळात असं होतं की आपलं सुखदुःख सांगायला जागा नव्हती कुणी ऐकणारं नव्हतं जर माझंच मी सांगते की आम्ही एक पायलीभर म्हणजे 5 किलो दळण दळायला लागायचं आम्हाला रोज दोघी जावांना सकाळी उठलं की जात्यावर बसायचं 5 किलो दळण दळत तरच सगळा घरात येडा यायचा आणि 10 किलो भात कांडायचं उकळावरती तेव्हा ते 3-4 दिवस भाताला जायचं तर 4:45 आम्ही जात्यावर बसायचो आणि म्हणून मग त्या ओवीत त्या बाईला सांगितलं परंपरेने का बाईना सांगितलं की बाई तुला जर लय सुख दुःख आहे ना तुला सांगायला जागा नाही तर तू पाठ उठलीस ना त्या जात्यावर जर बसलीस तर त्या जात्याला सांग तुझं तो डोंगरचा ऋषी आहे तो देव आहे आणि त्याला तो तुझं ऐकल म्हणून तू हृदय उकल त्याच्यापाशी मग तुझ्या मनात काय दुःख ते सगळं तू त्या जात्याला सांग
नाही कशाच अस यार ग नाही कशाच अस यार बाई सुईन बाईनी केला हाताचा कास यार ग केला हाताचा कास यार बाई धावत पळत कुठ चालला देव राया रे कुठ चालला देव राया
अशा वेळी आपली सुख दुःख किंवा संसारातले अनुभव काय आणखीन मुलांच्या बद्दल काय बोलायचं काही त्यांच्या मनात येईल ते मोकळेपणाने एकमेकीला सांगायचे ते त्या एकमेकांना त्यावेळेस तिथं सांगायच्या पण हे करत असताना त्यांनी एवढे विविध विषय त्याच्यात आणलेले आहेत की तो आवाका बघूनच मी म्हटलं की भाषांतरा करता हे मोठं आव्हान आहे
पण नंतर असं लक्षात आलं की जात्यावरील गाणी नंतर आम्ही ज्या दंतकथा असतात समाज आपल्याबद्दल आपली ओळख काय समाजाची आयडेंटिटी काय त्यासाठी ते लोककथा सांगायचे दंतकथा सांगायचे नंतर काही इतरही गाणी होती लोकगीतं होती मग त्या गीतातनं समाज कसा दिसतो समाजाचं जे पारंपरिक ज्ञान आहे ते ज्ञान ह्यामध्ये आम्हाला जाणवलं म्हणजे आता जर जात्यावरील गाण्यात बघितलं आपण तर शेतीबद्दल खूप त्यांनी सांगितलं असं म्हणतात की स्त्रियांनी शेतीची सुरुवात केली आणि स्त्रियांकडे इतकं ज्ञान आहे त्या वाऱ्याचं नक्षत्रांचं त्याच्याबद्दलही त्या बोलतात शेतीची बैलाला कोणता चारा द्यावा काय झाल्यावर कोणताच खाऊ घालावं त्याला याबद्दल पण बघूयात म्हणजे इतकं बारीक निरीक्षण आहे आणि त्यांच्या या ज्ञानाकडे दुर्लक्ष केलं गेलेलं आहे
Gee and Hema worked on the Grind Mill songs for many years before handing the project over to Bernard Bell in the 90s. The song transcripts were systematically indexed, classified and stored in a cabinet at Hema and Gee's house. Bell is a computational musicologist and former engineer at the French National Center for Scientific Research.
My first amazement was the accuracy of text transmitted by women singers. Most of whom in those days were illiterate. Not only the very same texts were recited by several informants living in very remote places, but also the same person was able to repeat hundreds of song texts after years. Indeed, I later understood that this is facilitated by the fact that these texts have strong phonetic and semantic structures characteristic of poetic styles.
So what happens is usually women sing these songs, there will be more than one woman sitting, you know. I mean, they used to do that. They don't do that so much anymore. She would be sitting in the corner of her kitchen or in the veranda and using the grind mill to do the day's, you know, make the day's flour and usually wheat or jowar or whatever. And while doing it, she sings this song, and let's say her daughter-in-law or her daughter is with her and they are singing, and tomorrow the daughter gets married and goes to another village. And there are daughters who are already married into other villages and they come home, you know, to their mother's home. So there's a lot of movement of women from village to village, district to district, one part of Maharashtra to another part of Maharashtra. And that's how the songs have been moving about.
Pari's involvement with the Ganmo song started in May 2016 after Bernard reached out to us. Over 7 years later, and we still cannot begin to quantify the value of these songs. Led by managing editor Namita Wiker, the team has met many of the women who are still alive today and who sang these songs once upon a time and today as well. We've documented their stories and learned from them, musically and otherwise.
Most important thing is that all the songs rhyme. You know how difficult it is to create rhymes, and this is like a collection of 1,10,000 songs, like 110,000 songs, and each one of them rhymes. So, and we are speaking about women who have not been trained in this, you know, they've not received any formal training, they have not been to a university, they've not done any creative writing. It's all their inbuilt talent. And they've done this while they're working.
Some of these women also participated in larger social reformation movements with an organization called the Garib Dongri Sangatna. They work with the poor in hilly areas of Pune district. These women performed street plays that were about dowry, domestic abuse, and other ills that were rampant in their homes.
तुम्ही आम्हाला म्हणता की बाया काय अडाणी, त्या काय बाईची जातन चुलीची राख, बाईची जातन कांद्याची पात, असं त्यांना हुकम दिलेली. बाई म्हणजे पायातली चप्पल, बाई म्हणजे पायातली वाण. मग तुम्ही आम्हाला असे म्हणता ना, तर मग शो एवढा ठेवा कोणी दिला आम्हाला, पण त्याला कुठली डिग्री नाही मिळाली आणि त्याला कुठल्या विद्यापीठात आम्ही गेलो नाही. हे आमचा ठेवा आहे आणि आम्ही तयार केला.
The movement also documented women like Gangubai Ambore afflicted by poverty and illness. Gangubai was brought up lovingly by her parents, both farmers. They arranged her marriage at a very young age to a much older man. She was initially happy in her marital home and had three daughters, although only one survived. But after a while, Gangubai was diagnosed with leprosy, and then everything changed. Her looks, she lost her toes and fingers, and her husband refused to accept this change or take care of her. Gangubai Ambore of Tadkalas village in Parbani district sang songs suffused with sorrow. Her voice spoke of the long years of loneliness and it captivated listeners.
Ka कोणरडत वाईका किते लाग समजावाया होई बाबळी बाईगा.
तुम्हाला ज्यांना कुणाला खरंच माणूस समजून घ्यायचा असेल, खरा माणूस समजून घ्यायचा असेल, तर तुम्ही ह्या ओव्यांचा अभ्यास केला पाहिजे.
पड पड तुम्ही अग राजा अर्थ पडून बरा केलं गर्थ पडून बरा केलं बरा केलं अर्थ पडून बरा केलं अर्थ पडून बरा केलं अग नंतर गुबाचा.